feed the VTY lines to use AAA for Telnet. All right? Not that you should be using Telnet, but this is what they have in the example. All right, and finally in R3, we're going to use AAA authentication with a TACAX Plus server for R2. And part 4, same thing, except we're going to be using Radius with R3. So, looking at the topology, you'll see have this topology for a couple of homework assignments throughout the course. R1, R2, and R3, our TACAX Plus server and our Radius server. All right, now you can test all of these via the different PCs for logging into the routers once the configuration is done. All right, I'll leave that to you guys. I might show one example like with the Telnet or with the SSH. All right, so with that, let's get started. All right, so for this, your admin1 password is going to be admin1pa55. Your TACAX keyword is TACAX PA55, and your Radius keyword password is Radius PA55. Alright. Let's keep all that in mind. So let's go ahead and get into R1. EMP855 like you had in the previous weeks. Alright. I'm going to skip around here a little bit. Go ahead and create the username, the user. Go to the configuration mode. Username, admin1, secret, admin1pa55. Okay, pretty easy. Now, to enable AAA on any router, we have to first start the AAA engine. The command to do that is AAA new-model from global configuration mode. AAA new-model, M-O-D-E-L. Okay, that turns on the authentication engine. Okay. So we need to configure it for console login to use the local database. So with AAA, you can set up three different things: authentication, authorization, and accounting. Regardless, you have to set up authentication. Why? Because authorization and accounting will not work without first having authentication running. So the purpose behind this activity is primarily to teach you how to set up authentication. You set up authentication for a bunch of different things. Primarily though, for remote access to the device. You can also set it up for local access via the console port, which is what we're going to do in this first step. All right, so the first command, AAA, and then authentication, all right, followed by what we're going to use. In this case, we're going to use it for logins. We can set it up for the enable password, or we can set it up for point-to-point protocol if we're doing authentication on a link between two routers. We're not going to do that. We're going to use it for logging. All right. And here we have to kind of look at, well, what are we using this for? So we're going to configure AAA authentication for console login to use the local database. That's going to be, did they give you a name for the local database? I don't think they do. Default is going to be in step 4. So it should be login, console, This is arbitrary. Local. Local sets it for local username authentication. Okay, so again, I'm on step three. Console login to use a local database. So AAA, authentication, login, console, local. That's it. All right. Then we want to set it up to use the default method of using console login. That's on the console line. So we will go to line con 0. Alright. And then we're going to use the word login authentication default. Okay. I actually think I goofed up here. Should have read ahead. This is why you read through the entire thing before you do it. I actually don't need to call this out by console. I'm going to take that out. I think this just needs to be default. Authentication login default local. That's it. And wonderful thing about Packet Tracer is you can always check it. Hey, looks like I got it right. Oh, maybe not. Maybe I needed to have that in there. Okay, maybe I'm getting ahead of myself.
Did you see that? I passed out, dude. Almost dropped the phone. That shit was hilarious. Wow.
Ah, that's why. I haven't done it yet for the other authentication method. That's why I haven't done it.
Did you finish the lab?
Okay. No problem.
Yeah, I needed that.
That is actually all of part one that we had to do. Those two commands, three commands, AAA new model, the authentication, default, local, and then on the line, the console line. So, to review. We're looking for that. This, and this, okay, along with your user, which is right there. All right, part two, configure a named list AAA authentication method for BTY lines on R1. Configure a name list called telnet-login to authenticate logins using local AAA. All right, so a name list called telnet-login is going to be slightly different. All right, so I actually need to take that out, that one that says console out. Instead, it will be AAA authentication telnet dash login again, this is the local database, I believe. Yeah, local AAA. Local. AAA authentication login, telnet-login. Telnet-login is just a name. It's like naming an access list. All right? It will tie to the virtual terminal lines on R1 when we go and configure the virtual terminal. How you do that is line BTY and all the lines 0 space 4. Alright. So again, very similar to the console port. Login. Authentication. And then you tie it to telnet dash login. Oh yeah, gosh, 10 points, wow. We're halfway done, folks. And here's the other authentication. Now, the reason that is you look at all these lines that are, that line is the point, right?
Thank you.
So part one gets you like halfway home. Part two. Actually, part two, one and two get you halfway home. All right. So, part three, configuring server-based authentication using TACAX Plus. Now we're on R2, so we're done with R1. Let's go ahead and close that out. Let's go ahead and get into R2 here. We'll also have to configure this TACAX server as well, okay? We might have to, I can't remember if we go into it. But to do that, you go to services, and you look for AAA. Here on AAA, they have it turned on. Am I on the radio server? That was on the TACAX server. I know, but it's server type TACAX. Okay. I guess, oh, this is to add it in there to the database. So it's already in there. Your client's in there. It's IP address to identify it. And look, the key, TACAX PA55. So that should already be in there. Again, you're just configuring the router. Now, same thing. We've got to turn on AAA new model to get the engine running. We've got to tell it that we want to use AAA authentication, this time with TACAX as the authentication methodology. Okay? So, again, now we got to make a user called admin2. AAA new dash model, that turns the AAA engine on. And now we can set up the AAA authentication schema. Alright. Again, it's for logins. Alright. Now, okay, we can set the default methodology up for this. I think it's what they want us to do. Enable AAA R2 and configure logins to authenticate using AAA TACAX server. And if not available, the local data. Ooh, they want us to do twofold. Okay? Huh. For your AAA authentication for console, logging the default AAA method. We did that before. So, we need to name this something. Let's call it TACAX. TACAX Plus. And then that guy plus, and if not available, the local database. So what you can do with AAA authentication is you can daisy chain methodologies together. So for example, you have a TACAC server and somebody takes that TACAC server offline. Well, if that TACAC server is offline, and the only way you can authenticate users to log into a router or a switch or whatever is TACAC server, you're not gonna be able to get in there unless you walk your happy butt over to the router or whatever and plug a console cable into it. Well, you can default or have a backup plan, if you will, to look at the local database as well. All right? And how we do that is we just put local next. All right? And we can do up to three. VTY line, login, authentication, TACAC, it's got match. All right. They also wanted us to set up the console port just like you did in R1. I'll let you guys do that. Check here, check results. Oh, we got one more. Ooh, I didn't get the authentication command right though. Oh, I also got put in the server key. Almost forgot that. It's okay. I think they wanted it to be default, not named. Get that out. So I also have to set up the console line and the TACAC portion. So to set up TACAC, you've got to give it its key and you got to tell it the IP address of the TACAC server. Alright? You'd use the TACAC-server command. Okay. Host and its IP address. So the IP address of this guy was something, right? TACAC. Okie dokie. 2.2. And then to set the key up, key, and then your password, which was what? TACAC P855. Console line, you go to your console line and you can set it up in the default method as well. So I think check results. Yeah, it's like up to 15 points now. So on that console line, you go to the console line and do the AAA authentication. Alright, so we just have R3 to do. Okay, so here's the thing. R3 is pretty much the same way, but instead of Pacax-server, it's Radius-server, host, IP address of the Radius server. Instead of Pacax key, it's Radius-server key, the password. BTY line is the same, the AAA command is the same, they'll be default. Alright? So I've given you, gosh, 2/3 of this thing, at least 3/4 of it, almost. You wanted a little bit of additional help? Not a problem. Go into your slides. Should be in chapter 3. They walk you through all the different methodologies for setting up authentication on a router. So this will go pretty quick next week. I'm going to go over this next week in more detail, but as you can see here, just to get it up and running, AAA new model, AAA authentication, login default, local best cases. I shortened it. Okay, username, password, etc. Okay, so that was local authentication. And then with TACAX and Radius, we'll go over this a little bit more in depth as far as the theory behind it and everything else next week. Comparison of the two, etc. But here we get into slide 34. Okay, TACAX server. Okay, here we're setting up an actual host name. You can do that. That won't suffice for the packet tracer lab, though. Be more along the lines of just the host and key, etc. So be kind of cautious around that. This is the newer way of doing things. What I showed you is kind of the way that you do it on older equipment. Questions? Question mark. Question. I heard somebody talking about that in the lab the other day. Like, man, packet tracer. One thing I learned, question mark. He was a student from Professor Schneider's class. All right, let's talk about lab 2. So, with lab